This is my 7th year coming to plays and performances here at Florida Christian, and every year tops the year before, and I really do see it, mean it. The direction that we have from Mrs. Bryant, Mrs. Stemmer, and Mr. Tyndall. It really is fantastic. So I'd like to just open us up in a word of prayer, and we'll get on with the show. So let's pray. Dear Father, thank you so much for Florida Christian. Thank you for the blessings that you've given us through the leadership and direction that we have at all levels. And Father, I thank you for the families that participate here at Florida Christian. I thank you for those that are here tonight for the first time. I pray that you'll be with them, be with their families. I pray for those who have been many years. I pray for those that have come back to watch their alma mater perform tonight. Thank you for those students and the difference in how they're changing the world for you out in colleges across the country. Father, I pray that you'll be with the cast, the band members, the singers, with the leadership, the backstage, that you'll bless them all, the sound, that they could have an amazing show tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. Enjoy Cinderella.
I just wish I was doing something more important with my life.
Worrying about that self-worth again, Prince Topher.
It all just comes too easily.
The fact remains, sire, you will be king and very soon. When your sainted mother and father passed away and left you in my charge, I promised them that when you came of age, you would be prepared for your reign.
Yes, yes, I know, and I guess I am ready to be king. The thing is, I don't even know who I am yet.
I'm sure it will come to you. Until then, might I suggest faking it?
Ah, really?
Well, you wouldn't be the first, and you wouldn't be the last.
To the castle.
To the castle. Ah. Still, these questions nag me. Nag, nag, nag. No, not you, Buttercup. Still, I wonder. Me, who am I? A far from perfect guy. A bum who wants to do what's right, but often does what's wrong. A kid whose voice is way off key, but loves to sing a song. A guy who dreams like a lion, but wakes up like a lamb. Me, who am I, but the guy I am?
Slayer of dragons, pitiless to ogres, destroyer of griffins and giants, no friend to gargoyles, nice to the needy, sportsman and poet, a guy who dreams like a lion, but wakes up like a
dragon!
Me, who am I but the guy I am?
He's our hero.
Oh, stop.
Such perfection.
That's very kind of you.
He's the kind of guy who we'd all like to be.
Too much.
What's the use of self-reflection?
Too much, too much.
Church bells will ring when you are king. People will sing. There is no one quite like
me.
His Royal Highness.
Who am I?
Christopher Rupert.
A far
slayer
from
of dragons.
Perfect guy.
Pitiless to ogres.
A jerk who wants to do what's right, but often
no
does what's wrong.
Royals.
A drip
nice
whose voice is way off key, but loves to sing a song.
Poets.
A guy who dreams like a lion, but wakes up like a lamb. Me, who am I, but the guy I am?
What a guy, what a guy, what a guy, what a guy, what a guy.
He's a plain and simple,
impoverished person. Fetch us some water.
Yes, sir.
Hey, don't speak to her that way. How do you know she's poor?
Look at her. She's filthy.
Here you are, sire.
Thank you, young lady. It's very kind of you.
It's just water.
Give her some money.
Really?
Oh, yes, it's charity. You have things and she doesn't. You will give her some of your things so she doesn't have a revolution and take all of your things. The moment charity is mentioned, out comes every layabout.
Here you are, old woman.
Oh, thank you. Bless you, kind sir.
Be careful, my lord. Many of the very poor have weapons.
Be gone with you.
No! Good sirs, this is merely Crazy Marie. She only comes to town to gather what others throw away. She is gentle in every way, sweet and delicate, but nuts.
She's harmless. Sebastian, Lord Pinkleton, sheathe your swords. You're a great friend to Marie. How lucky she is to have a friend such as you. I wish I had a true friend in this world.
I'm standing right here.
Shall we journey on?
Very well, Pinkleton. Farewell, young lady.
Oh, I don't want any charity.
Take the coin, then, as a gift for a true friend in this world. Sorry, lot on my mind.
Ahem! Oh, thank you. Bless you, kind. Thank you so much for saving my life, dear Ella. I shall return the favor.
I didn't do it to have a favor returned.
I have a shawl here that only has a few holes and smells of cabbage. You can wear it.
Not necessary. What a handsome man that was, and so kind and generous.
That is but not a man. That is Prince Topher, the slayer of giants and dragons. He has just returned to us from the university. He is to be crowned king.
That man? A world leader? Well, but he appears to have a heart, mind, and soul. It can't be. Marie, you're crazy.
Yes. Yes, I am. But that does not change the fact that he is our very own Prince Topher, and he is to be our ruler. Look at your coin, dear.
Oh, why, it is him. From the left, such silly ears. And that big crown doesn't help things. He should wear a floppy hat. Here, Marie, please take this coin. Buy yourself something warm to eat.
Why is it always the very poorest who are the most generous? It breaks my heart.
And here is our John Michel. He will spout gibberish now and Boris.
Be nice. Good day, John Michel.
And do you know why, Ella and Crazy Marie, that the poorest are the most kindest?
No, but I have a feeling you are about to be the most forthcoming.
Because it is a corrupt system with a smash moral compass.
You will forgive me if I just stagger about and mutter.
Today, I will be going alone to the palace steps to protest the corruption that riddles our government. You must come with me, both of you.
Cinderella!
That is Madame, Ella's stepmother.
I will shout to the prince. He will have no choice but to listen.
Cinderella!
You are in harm's way.
I have a vision for what this kingdom could be.
Cinderella, help me with my parcels this instant. Careful, careful. No one knows the extreme torture I'm subjected to. I'm ignoring that. Lovely daughters, come, come.
We're here, Mama. We are exhausted being as beautiful as we look.
Cinderella! Aye, old girl. Help your stepsisters with their shrewd purchases. Into the house, daughters. The real ones.
Madame isn't always mean. Sometimes she sleeps.
Gabrielle, I have brought with me a book from university with pictures of how people in other lands live and how they govern. Norway, Italy, Japan.
I have mentioned my interest in these places only in passing, and you have brought me a whole book? Could it, you?
And 4 days from now, I would like to take you on a date. I'm organizing a soup kitchen. We need someone to stir and ladle.
Gabrielle, do not talk to that man. We are teetering precariously between upper middle class and lower upper class. We cannot be seen with a revolutionary. Into this house at once.
Why do I care? Why do I try? I'll never be good enough for her. I'll take this book and burn it!
Why not give the book to dear Ella?
If it's quite all right, John Michel, I would love to look at your book of how other countries live.
And here, take it, Ella. I shall go on my way alone, live my own life. I'm a loner. You're coming with me, right?
Of course.
Good.
A book. It's been so long since I've owned something just me.
Cinderella, get in here and clean the kitchen.
I've just finished it.
Then prepare dinner.
It's on the stove.
Then the beds mossed.
Beds are all turned down and your bed clothing is all laid out.
Well, where'd you get that book?
Jean Michel gave it to me.
How lovely. People just give you gifts. Still daddy's little girl. And what's this?
That's my father's coat.
It's rags.
It's all I have to remember him by.
It's rags now. Clean the porch with these rags.
I'm as mild pass. When I hear a command, I obey. But I know of a spot in my house where no one can stand in my way. In my own little corner, in my own little chair, I can be whatever I want to be. Fly anywhere, and the world will open its arms to me. I'm a young Norwegian princess or a milkmaid. I'm the greatest prima donna in Milan. I'm an heiress who has always had her silk made by her own flock of silkworms in Japan. I'm a girl men go mad for, love's a game I can play with a cool and confident kind of air. But just as long as I stay in my own little corner, all alone in my own little chair. Queen in Peru, I'm a mermaid dancing upon the sea. I'm a huntress on an African safari. It's a dangerous type of sport, and yet it's fun. In the night, I sally forth to seek my quarry, and I find I forgot to bring my unarmed when I meet a lioness in her lair. Then I'm glad to be back in my own little corner, all alone in my own little chair.
Just as long as I stay in my own little corner,
all alone
in my own little chair.
Your Majesty, a list of the lords entreating thee.
A list of the lords entreating me with what?
105 requests.
That seems a lot.
I'll take this. Your Majestic Highness, in honor of your upcoming coronation, we proudly proclaim your land a kingdom of plenty and bounty. May I have the imprimatur of your ring on this other announcement?
Right. Sorry, what's it for again?
Oh, it's complicated. Do you really want me to get into it?
Prince Topher, listen!
What's that?
The people are being treated unfairly by your government!
Who's that screaming on the other side of the moat?
You need to take responsibility for your actions!
He seems upset.
Rabble rouser, ignore him! I have this new law which forbids any! Actually, if you would hand me the ring, it would save the trip.
Right, sorry. We should invite him up to talk. Nobody was this upset with Mom and Dad, were they?
Your parents had the good fortune of being royalty in a time of plenty. But since your unfortunate demise, I have done my best to run this country. I have done my best to raise you in the finest schools.
Hello? I'm talking here!
Ignore him!
I won't give up. If you won't listen to me, I'll shout this to the town square.
Shout this to the town square? Perhaps it's time for a distraction.
Ooh, what kind of distraction?
A royal wedding.
Wow. And does that work?
Like a dream every time.
But who'll get married?
Well, you.
Me? But I don't know any girls. I went to an all-boys school off in the woods and an all-male university on an island. Why'd you do that to me?
For this happy day, I'm going to find you a bride. Oh, happy the day.
But how'll you find me a bride?
We shall have a magnificent ball. Dancing.
What?
Every eligible young woman who can afford a gown will attend the ball. That is a wonderful selection process right there. If you cannot afford a nice dress, you have no business marrying a prince. Now, all the guests will be in masks. You will dance with every girl. At the stroke of midnight, everyone will have removed their mask, and you will have found your bride.
That's fast.
King and queen on the throne, I'm there to guide you through all of your decisions. It's really a win-win.
But who'll fall in love with me so quickly?
A valid question, which we will answer sometime soon. Now, Lord Pinkleton, I want you to tell this to all. A pronouncement. An announcement. His Royal Highness, Christopher Rupert, Windermere Vladimir, Carl Alexander.
Please don't say my whole
Francois
name.
Francois Reginald.
It's embarrassing.
Lancelot Herman.
Herman?
Herman. Gregory James is giving a ball.
Sebastian dancing? Can we please talk about this?
Now is the time to act. No other time will do. Live and play your part. Don't give away your heart. Don't take what the world gives you. No, 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 listen. Tradespeople, tinkers, fishmongers. I shout to the prince, but he ignores me. If him and Sebastian think that they can take the land from the very poor, it's only a matter of time before they start to take from all of us. For you just can't wait to be served by fate on a silver plate or a tray.
Now is the time of your life, the time of your life is today.
The prince is giving a ball, the prince is giving a ball. Hear ye, a ball, and that's not all. The prince is giving a ball. James is giving a ball.
He's giving a ball.
The prince is giving a ball. The prince is giving.
Hey, now is the time to act.
Right.
Now is the time to live.
The prince is giving a ball.
Hey,
shh. He's giving a ball. The prince is giving a ball.
His Royal Highness, Christopher Rupert. Windermere, Vladimir, Carl Alexander, Francois Reginald, Lancelot, Herman.
Herman?
Herman. Gregory James is giving a ball.
The prince is giving a what?
The prince is giving a ball. The prince is giving a ball.
His Majesty has this decree. To attend the ball, all requires is an invitation and suitably fashionable attire, and the prince will choose someone from the ball to be his bride. That means any of you can be the queen.
So will he want a taller girl?
Will he want a stronger girl?
Or will he want a smaller girl?
The prince is giving a ball.
I wish I were a younger girl.
I wish I had, I wish I could,
I wish I might.
he's giving a ball, he's giving a ball, the prince is giving a ball.
Now is the time to act. The time to live.
His Royal Highness Christopher Rupert, Slayer of Dragons, Destroyer of Gorgons, Scholar and Poet.
All the dreamers in the world are poppycock and twaddle. The prince is giving a ball.
Once you finish tightening Delicate Charlotte's corset...
Oh, I can taste my lunch!
Then you must move on to Gabrielle's hair. It's beginning to look, I fear,
like a Bavarian pretzel!
Cinderella! Cinderella! Cinderella!
Cinderella! It is the most amusing name! I crack myself up! Her name is Ella, and she sits by the cinders of the fire. So I call her Cinder Ella.
Why don't I have any friends?
Face it, Mama. You are well versed in the art of ridicule.
I do have a flair for it, don't I, actual daughters? Watch and learn. Cinderella, hurry, get dressed quick. You're going to the ball. You're going to find a husband.
I am?
Ridicule. Who got it?
I did. That's terrible.
Who could that be at this hour? Everyone clear out of here while I get rid of this imbecile. What brand of an idiot would? Why, Sebastian. What an unexpected delight.
Madam, I have but a moment. I invite you to hang upon my every word.
Invitation accepted.
Tonight's ball shall be in masks. The prince will be wearing a white mask. What color mask will your daughter Gabrielle be wearing?
Why, pink.
If the daughter is anything like the mother, I think the pink mask and the white mask shall meet and fall in love.
Are you implying what I'm inferring?
Your daughter is all part of my master plan.
You are brilliant!
You are perceptive. I shall see you at the ball. Together, we shall make this so.
Daughters, come in, quick! Oh, Gabrielle, look at you! You too, Charlotte. But really, look at Gabrielle! Cinderella, bring me the orange box. Necklaces made out of Venetian glass, more valuable than diamonds. Each one of you shall wear the tiniest bauble around your neck. Here is for my beautiful daughter, Gabrielle. And here
is a necklace for my courageous Charlotte. Who can that be at the door? It must be good news.
Good evening, madame. Gabrielle, forgive me for interrupting your momentous evening, but I thought you might want to take these to the ball tonight. Wildflowers, I picked them myself.
Thank you, Jean-Michel, they're so beautiful.
For the mother of the most perfect girl in all God's creation, I've picked these myself and—
Leave! And take your simple pleasures with you!
Would you perhaps consider if I—
No!
Madame, don't be so mean, that was so nice.
No! Plans, there are plans that do not include Mr. Soapbox!
But he means, well, and I think he likes me.
Let me tell you something about love, Miss Flowers in your hands and dreams in your head. I married your father for love. He died, and I cried. Then I married Cinderella's father for money. He died, and I got a house. 7:30, ball preparations, double time. Cinderella, my shoes. Venetian glass.
I'm hungry.
Gabrielle, feed the baby. Cinderella, my cloak. Expensive bracelet, necklace, hair. Then the prince we shall ensnare.
Then the prince we shall ensnare.
Are we worthy?
Yes, yes.
To battle my daughter, the crown is ours to lose. Posture, posture. Tonight is the night everything changes.
Expensive bracelet, necklace, hair. Then the prince we shall ensnare.
Invitations.
Expensive bracelet, necklace, hair. Cinderella isn't going anywhere.
One of the flowers in the bouquet was a wild rose. Its thorn has scratched my lip. I'm bleeding. I should walk up to the prince, scratch his lip.
Oh, now.
Make him drink lemonade, make it sting.
That's just cruel.
Enough of taking things as they are. Now's the time for us, the peasants, the tradespeople, to march up to the palace steps and convince the prince to listen to us instead of having his fancy ball.
You should do that. You should go to the prince and talk to him.
He won't listen to me. He uses his castle to hide from the truth. Him meeting me will never happen. The only thing funnier would be if you went to the ball. You know what? Yeah, why don't you go to the ball and ask the prince when he's gonna start noticing that the people are being evicted from their land. It's absurd.
Jean-Michel! I could go to the prince, and he might even listen to me. And well, maybe if I had a ball gown, I think I might look sort of nice. I am in the royal palace of all places. When you meet the finest prince you'll ever see, and the color on my two stepsisters' faces is a queer sort of sour apple green. I am coy and flirtatious when alone with the prince. I'm the belle of the ball in my own little corner, all alone in my own little chair.
Roy and fiddle-dee-dee, fiddle-dee-faddle-dee-faddle. poppycock and what?
Crazy Marie, are you mocking me with your gibberish?
Yes. Falderoy and fiddle-dee-dee, fiddle-dee-faddle-dee-foodle. All the dreamers in the world are dizzy in the noodle.
So what if I have a dream to see the prince again? And to tell him what life in his kingdom is really like and what it can be?
Exactly! Then you'd have to have him fall in love with you.
No one will fall in love with me. Why do you come to visit me tonight?
I just knew I would find you in the same little chair, in the pale pink mist of a foolish dream.
I am being foolish.
Then be foolish with me. Now tell me, what is it you dream of?
Why, an invitation to the ball, I guess?
Well, right here. There's an invitation.
What? But it's torn.
Don't wait for everything to be perfect. Just go. Now tell me what else it is you dream of.
Well, a white gown, a beautiful white gown sewn with pearls and jewels, and a tiara of diamonds.
And on your feet?
Why, the most beautiful pair of grosgrain pumps, I'd imagine.
No better. The Venetian glass that your stepmother so loves in her trinkets and baubles. An entire pair of shoes made only of Venetian glass.
How silly. I'd be the envy of all. Well, but how would I get to the ball?
Well, this pumpkin right here.
Yes?
I'll turn it into a golden carriage.
Oh, and horses?
Those mice trapped in this cage.
Oh, and a fox as a footman, and a raccoon as a driver. You are crazy, Marie. Well, why, in order to do that, you would have to be a fairy godmother. You're a crazy woman. What are you doing in that beautiful gown?
You'd be surprised at how many beautiful gowns have crazy women in them.
Are you really my fairy godmother?
Yes, my child. Actually, I'm everyone's fairy godmother. But you're the only one who's ever given me kindness, generosity, and charity. And now I must make all the jokes that we dreamed about come true.
Oh, that's so improbable. Implausible!
Impossible for a plain yellow pumpkin to become a golden carriage. Impossible for this plain country bumpkin and a prince to join in marriage. And four white mice will never be four white horses. Just leave it here. And Falderoy and Fiddle-dee-dee, of course, is impossible.
Well, then anything is possible, right?
I suppose so.
Well, then you could change it all. You can make it all happen.
No, you can change it all. You can make it all happen.
Oh, never. I couldn't.
You're right. It's just all... Oh, my goodness. It's just all so impossible for a plain yellow pumpkin to become a golden carriage. Impossible. For this plain country bumpkin and a prince to join in marriage. And four white mice will never be four white horses. Such Falderoy and Fiddle-dee-dee, of course, is impossible.
But the world is and in a straight line, too. All right, Mr. Fox, your turn. Let's go. Come on. Yes. Wonderful. All right, Mr. Raccoon, it's your turn. Oh, my goodness. One, two, three, go. Ah, yes. So handsome. Cinderella, I must tell you. Now promised in our laughter, Venetian glass slippers. Just like royalty. Now, Cinderella, I must tell you. This magic is all very powerful, but it will end at midnight. Now go, go to the ball in the name of every girl that wished to go to the ball in a beautiful dress. Go in the name of every girl that wished to change the world she lived in. Go with the promise of possibility.
It's possible, it's possible, it's possible, it's possible, it's possible, it's possible for a plain yellow pumpkin to become a golden carriage. It's possible for a plain country bumpkin and a prince to join in marriage, and four white mice are easily turned to horses. Such full
Sebastian, honestly.
Only 200 women to go.
So, which one is he here?
Which one is which?
The prince, duh. Which one is the prince? What do you think I'm here for? The free food?
Well, a good time, a dance, perhaps?
Wrong answer. I've got marrying royalty in my mind. So, which one is he?
Well, Maybe it's me.
Unlikely. You're too ordinary.
What makes you think I'm ordinary?
We're doing the vaude and you can't even keep the beat. When we get to the waltz, you're gonna trip over your two left feet and land in your flat little bottom. End of discussion.
Well, hope to talk to you later then.
I've moved on.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Lovely dance, isn't it? I hope my dancing's all right.
Oh, you're dancing awfully princely. Oops, I let that slip out.
Well, that last girl didn't know.
You're kidding! Well, thanks for the heads up!
I think she knows now.
Well...
So...
Tell me something about yourself.
What you would like to know, Your Highness?
What are some of your interests?
Oh, any of your interests, Your Highness.
Okay, creepy!
Your Most Majestic Highness, just because I was playing hard to get doesn't mean I'm hard to get.
Okay, very creepy. I'm sorry, Sebastian. I don't think I can do this anymore.
It's the prince!
What happened to the nice girl?
Ignore her. We're playing ridicule. You be the judge. Two circles spin, and when the music stops, two players will out-ridicule one another. Let's find you a bride. Stop! You and you.
My dear... I love your dress, no matter how many times I've seen it. Why, I remember when it was first in fashion, when I was a young girl.
Please do not talk about your childhood, as I had not brought along a copy of the Old Testament to follow along.
What do you even call that?
Well, it's awfully sophisticated.
Seems more like cruelty to me.
Sophisticated, cruelty, it's a slight difference there. I keep forgetting what it is.
I don't want to play anymore.
And here we have another round at the ready! You and you.
Age before beauty. You first, dear.
I love your speaking voice. Have you ever considered reciting poetry?
Say it. What? Do it. What? The anticipation is killing me. Do the ridicule. Why do you do this to me?
No reason. I just really like your speaking voice, and I think it would sound just lovely reciting poetry. And I love the feather in your hair. It's a wonderful color for you.
Why are you doing this to me?
What is this bewitchery you practice?
It's just kindness.
Kindness?
Oh, yes. Kindness is used everywhere now. Ridicule isn't used anywhere anymore. It's all kindness now, even in the French courts.
Kindness?
Yes. You know, compassion.
Who are you, you strange woman?
I don't know who she is, but she is very wealthy indeed. And did you see her feet? Shoes made out of Venetian glass. My resentment is all-consuming.
Kindness, you all must try it.
Kindness, I'll be the first. How wonderful it is to have someone such as you in our courts.
Thank you. And it's an honor to be at this wonderful party you're throwing.
Ugh, it's like every time they speak, a part of me dies.
You know, I must say, this courtroom is filled with some of the loveliest women I have ever seen.
I just saw that they had this vanilla cake at the buffet, and I'm in love with this vanilla cake. Thank you to whoever made it.
This floor is filled with laughter and warmth.
Like it was during the time of Prince Topher's parents.
May his reign be a continuation of theirs.
Those were glorious days.
Look at all these magnificent guests.
Thank you. You are so kind. You make me want to be a better person. But there's something somewhat familiar about you. I wonder what that could be.
I admire how you've changed everything around. And yet I'm still so comfortable with you. I feel like we've met before. Ten minutes ago, I saw you. I looked up when you came through the door. My head started reeling. You gave me the feeling. The room had no ceiling or floor. 10 minutes ago, I met you. And we murmured our how do you do's. I wanted to ring out the bells and fling out my arms and to sing out the news. I have found her. She's an angel with the dust of the stars in her eyes. We are dancing, we are flying, and she's taking me back to the skies. In the arms of my love, I'm flying over mountain and meadow and glen. And I like it so well, therefore all I can tell, I may never come down again. Down to earth again. I'm sorry to be so effusive. Events like this, I just feel like, what am I doing?
I feel the same.
Like such a phony.
So do I.
You do?
Yes.
Me too. My name's
Topher. Short for Christopher. Yes, I know.
Have we met before?
Yes. And we are seeing each other for the first time right now.
10 minutes ago, I met you, and we murmured our how do you do's. I wanted to ring out the bells and fling out my arms and to sing out the news. I have found him. I have found him. Flying over mountain and meadow and glen. And I like it so well that for all I can tell, I may never come down again.
I may never come down to earth again. taking me back to the skies. In the arms of my love, I'm flying over mountains and meadow and glen. And I like it so well, so well. And I like it so well. And I like it so well. For all I can tell, I may never come down. Never come down again.
I have to go.
But I've just found you.
I don't want to go, but I must.
Don't go.
Prince Topher, there's something I must tell you. You must open your eyes to what's going on in your kingdom. The poor are having their land taken away. You must help them. You must.
I don't think that's kind. How can you say that's kindness?
This is all so wonderful. You are so wonderful, but I have to go.
Wait, where are you going? Wait, young lady, please stop.
Your Highness, Your Highness.
Charlotte, Gabrielle.
Ladies and gentlemen, we will have a brief intermission. Thank you.
Thank you. too, man.
The Lord.
Your torches behind, then.
We must find this girl. She's my destiny.
Wait. Seriously, did that just happen? Seriously? Would a fellow want a girl like her? A frail and fluffy beauty? Why can't a fellow ever once prefer a solid girl like me? She's a frothy little bubble with a flimsy kind of charm. And with very little trouble, I could break her little arm.
Ow! Ow!
Why would a fellow want a girl like her? So obviously unusual. Why can't a fellow ever once prefer a usual girl like me?
Her face is exquisite, I suppose.
But no more exquisite than a rose is.
Her skin may be delicate and soft.
But not any softer than a doe's is. She's as a bird. So why is the fellow going crazy? Oh, why would a fellow want a girl like her? A girl who's nearly lovely. Why can a fellow ever once prefer a girl who's nearly me? What's the matter with the man? What's the matter with the man? What's the matter with the man?
Footwear's falling from the sky.
She's run off. She's taking a shortcut through the woods. Gentlemen, lanterns, we must find this girl. It's the last thing I do.
He's witty, so disarming, and I really like the way he holds a room. Clever, cunning, ever charming. How do I make him see I'm special? It's a pity.
It's a pity.
I'm as pretty.
I'm as pretty.
Plus, I've got the patience of a perfect saint. So I'm waiting, always waiting. Nevertheless, I'm in a mess. Loosen my dress. Help me, I'm starting to faint.
Why would a fellow want a girl like her? A girl who isn't dizzy. Why can a fellow ever once prefer
a high-strung girl like me? Her face is exquisite, I suppose.
What's the matter
but
with
no
the
more
man?
Exquisite than a rose is. Her skin may be delicate and soft. But not
man?
Any softer than a doe's is. Her neck is no wider than a swan's. She's only
man?
As dainty as a daisy. She's only
man?
As graceful as a bird. So why is a fellow going crazy? Oh, oh, why would a fellow want a girl like her? A girl who's nearly lovely. Why can't a fellow ever once prefer a girl who's merely me?
What's the matter with a man? What's the matter with a man? What's the matter with a man?
She's the matter, let me at her!
What's the matter with a man? What's the matter? What's the matter with the man?
What's the matter with the man?
Majesty.
Lord Pinkleton, where is she?
There are reports along the eastern road of a golden carriage.
Ten minutes ago, I held her.
Your Majesty, we saw the carriage! Impossible!
I know!
Impossible? Then we must do the impossible!
Yes.
Ten minutes ago, we were singing the palace of all places, and her gown was like a cloud of snowy white, and the moonlight shone its beams upon our faces till she vanished like a phantom in the night. I just know I will find you. You're the girl of my dreams, and the thrill is more than my heart can bear.
Look, a carriage!
That's the one! After her! To the west!
That my daughter was going to become queen, and I never would have to come back to this. And well, here I am back to this.
Was the ball a disappointment, madame?
The king, despite him being well-born and taken great care of by our Lord Protector, showed the most appalling manners. Appalling! He spent the entire evening dancing and talking with some little nobody.
Oh, and how did Gabrielle and Charlotte take that?
The prince has fallen head over heels for somebody else. If he keeps this up, I might not want to go out with him.
What was going on through His Royal Highness' thick skull?
The way he looked at her, with respect. Ugh. I hope no man ever looks at me that way.
If that man and woman had any sense of morality or what's right in this world, she wouldn't have gone to the ball at all.
But can you imagine how she must have felt arriving at the ball dancing with the man of her dreams?
I cannot. For my mind has no place for the puerile or rank.
I can imagine it, I think.
I can imagine it.
I can imagine it. And I have no imagination.
When you're driving through the moonlight on the highway, when you're driving through the moonlight to the dance, you are breathless with a wild anticipation of adventure and excitement and romance. The towers of the palace, silhouetted on the sky above the park, and below them is a row of lighted windows, like a lovely diamond necklace in the dark.
It looks that way,
the way you say.
She talks as if she knows.
So I only just suppose. I suppose that when you come into the ballroom and the room itself is floating in the air, if you're suddenly confronted by His Highness, you are frozen like a statue on the stair. You're afraid he'll hear the way your heart is beating.
more than a prince.
He's a nice.
But sisters, I really think I can.
Can what?
I think that I can picture such a man.
Too.
This squinting isn't my sinus condition. It's me imagining it.
I'm throwing caution to the wind. I'm imagining it as well.
And imagine what that girl must have felt when dancing with the prince. A lovely night. A lovely night. A finer night you know you'll never see. Prince, a charming prince, as charming as a prince will ever be. The stars in a hazy heaven tremble above you while he is whispering, darling, I love you. You say goodbye, away you fly, but on your lips you keep a kiss. All your life you'll dream of this love.
Charlotte, play the piano forte.
Okay, but it's not going to be very good. A lovely night, a lovely night, a finer night you know you'll never see.
La la la,
la la la.
You meet your prince,
your prince,
a charming prince, as charming as a prince will ever be.
La la la,
the stars in a hazy tremble above you while he is whispering, darling, I love you.
You say goodbye, away you fly, but on your lips you keep a kiss.
All your life you'll dream of this lovely, lovely
to comfort me after this disastrous evening is how absolutely devastated the prince looked when his dream date ran away.
Oh, it was hilarious. Yes, there was tons of yammering in the powder room about it. Why did the girl run away? My personal belief is that up close, she was physically unappealing.
To bed, my lovely daughters. Cinderella, clean up this pigsty of a parlor. And why is there a pumpkin on the table? It makes no design sense.
Is there anything else you'd like to know, Ella?
No, it really sounds like a magnificent ball. Only I wish I could have been there.
And how did you know everything that happened at the ball this evening?
Well, I just supposed it, imagined it, had a vision.
Interesting. Quick, how many fingers?
Two?
Three. Where are your visions now?
You're being silly. You're just teasing me because I said the prince was wearing a white jacket.
You did it. And
dance he was. Something's going on here.
You're being absurd. More than usual. I have to finish up here and...
Let me help you with that. Your hands are so rough and calloused from work. Just like the hand of the woman I shook at the ball who danced with the prince.
I don't know what you're talking about.
It was you, wasn't it? It was you. And how did you dance in glass shoes?
You won't tell the others, will you, Madame and Charlotte?
No, never.
Are you mad at me because I stole the prince from you?
I must confess a secret. I never loved the prince or even liked him. There's someone else that I want.
Oh, that's wonderful. Who is it?
Madame hates him.
Madame hating him doesn't narrow the field. Who is it?
If I promise to keep your secret of the prince, do you promise to keep my secret of my forbidden love?
I can, and I will.
It's Jean-Michel, the fire prince!
He's a good man, and, well, he seems angry for all the right reasons.
He wants to change the world and make it a better place, and you gotta love a guy like that.
Well, you may one day win Jean-Michel, but I will never win Prince Topher. If he saw me for who I truly was, he would never love me.
That's not true. He would love you for who you are.
I don't see how.
Well, I shudder at the thought of what Madame might do if she finds out about Jean-Michel. And are you sure you can keep my secret?
I can. We shall have a secret. That will make us...
Co-conspirators.
Friends.
Sisters.
May we both find our loves.
And our lives.
The stars in a hazy heaven, trembling above me, danced when he promised always to love me.
The day came through,
away I flew, but on my lips he left a kiss.
All my life I'll dream of this.
Lovely,
lovely,
lovely night.
I wake in the loneliness of sunrise, when the deep purple heaven turns blue, and start to pray as I pray each day that I'll hear some word from you. I wake in the loneliness of evening, when the sky is a rubber's then blue, and as the moon, oh how soon will my love come home to me? I have found her. She's an angel
with the dust of the stars in your eyes.
Sire, 3 nights in a row you search and here it is. 4 o'clock in the morning. It's as if you are testing my good nature. The second that woman in the white ran off, which we all must admit seems to imply that she has a police record. The second she is gone, you don't want to dance with any of the other girls.
Sebastian, are there people whose lands have been taken from them?
If there were, I would tell you.
Do they need our help?
Everyone donated joyfully. Ignore this talk. Where did you hear it?
The girl.
I don't know that she is to be trusted. Please come back to the palace. The work is piling up.
No, Something isn't right.
As you say. The ring, sire.
Right, what's it for again?
Nothing, sire, but hardly worth troubling your beautiful mind about.
Let me read it.
No. Your sire, I can explain before
I'm reading this.
Your Majestic Highness, please come back to the palace.
I'll read this now.
But
I'll let you know if I need anything explained, thank you. Oh no. Sebastian!
Sire, I can explain.
How can you do this in my name?
I'm maintaining this life for you. Without my watchful eye, you should be a pauper. Would you like that?
I want the girl. I want the girl that talked to me. I want to talk to that girl.
A troublemaker.
We're having another banquet, and she'll come to that.
She won't show. This is lunacy.
We're having another banquet, a ball, and you invite everyone in the kingdom.
Don't forget who you are talking to.
And don't forget who you're talking to. We're having another banquet.
Very well, sire. She won't show. You don't even know her name. And if she really thought you were worthy of all of her high ideals, she would have stayed. Wouldn't she?
A banquet!
The prince is looking dreamy-eyed. He has since giving the ball. And still he wants to find his bride, the one that he lost at the ball. So spread the word throughout the land, the prince is throwing a banquet.
Hear ye! Hear ye!
It is his wish that the woman that attended the ball will attend. As for the rest of us, well, what can I say? There's gonna be a ham. Talk it back to me!
Hear ye! Hear ye!
And of course, I want to keep an eye on what women are there. I am not giving up control this time. Spread the word!
Hear ye! Hear ye! His Royal Highness Christopher Rupert James is giving a banquet tonight. Invitation only.
A banquet tonight? Cinderella? Where are you? Cinderella? Where can you be?
His Royal Highness Christopher Rupert, dopey and dream-eyed, can't find his lady, hoping to see her, asking where is she?
Cinderella, where is she?
Gregory James is giving
a banquet tonight, two major social events in 1 week. This seems cruel. Now, I have never looked lovelier, but my physical perfection comes at a price. Gloves, that's what it was. Cinderella, where are my gloves?
Shh, Ella, quick. Don't tell her you have her gloves quite yet. Yes, I know she'll be abusive later, but trust me, it shall be worth it. I'm going to tell Madame that I'm sick.
Oh, would you like some?
I'm not really sick. I'm just pretending. It's just like when Charlotte was in school and she used to pretend to be sick to get out of things she didn't like the third and fourth grade. And as soon as we are leaving, I will be sick. Charlotte and Madame will leave and I will change back into my regular clothes and meet my secret crush, Jean-Michel. I'm taking him up on his offer to meet in the soup kitchen.
A soup kitchen?
I get to ladle. You heard me. And guess what will happen to both this invitation and one of my beautiful dresses? I shall loan them both to you, and you will go in my stead and meet the prince and fall in love and get married and exact revenge on Madame and keep Jean-Michel out of the stockade and cha-la-la, la-la-la, it's just the way my mind works.
Cinderella, where are my gloves?
And don't worry about Madame. She never notices anything that isn't her.
Your gloves are right here, Madame.
Cinderella, foolish child, why didn't you tell me you had my gloves? Charlotte, make haste, child. And remember, those shoes are delicate and dainty.
Oh, my feet burn with the heat of 1,000 suns.
To the carriage, my daughters.
Oh, Madame, my stomach. Something, I must have eaten something this morning that disagrees with me.
No. This cannot keep me from going to the ball tonight.
Go without me. Let Charlotte take the prince from the homely woman from the ball. Go, let Charlotte become queen.
I think I can work with that.
Well, Cinderella. You fetch the physician and make sure that Gabrielle gets better. Gabrielle, get better. I insist on it. And make sure you keep your invitation. Charlotte, to the carriage.
Thank you, Mother.
No, 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 not on the shoes! Charlotte, let's go.
Quick, I'll go change in. You knock on the door.
It knocked back.
Good evening, Ella.
Why, hello, Jean-Michel.
I'm sick of hiding in the shadows like a fearful person.
Would you rather see Madame?
Hiding is nice.
How are you this evening?
I'm going out with Gabrielle and I'm wound up like a tick. First we will go to the greengrocer and beg him for what scraps he might have left. Then we'll slave over a hot stove and deliver a meal to the very poor. I do hope she's not expecting this much fun every night.
And your dealings with the prince?
He still throws his fancy parties and pays no mind to me. May I?
Yes, of course.
Thank you. What might your plans be for this evening?
Oh, well, you know, with the banquet, Madame has to take Charlotte and I have to keep the place tidy.
Do you think Madame suspects me here?
Good evening, Jean-Michel.
Good evening, Gabrielle. I much prefer you in the simple attire. You no longer look like a carnival attraction.
You speak such kind words to me all the day long, and what of the soup kitchen?
Our first responsibility is with the poor. Then we shall march to the palace steps, and I shall speak with the prince. We have but one small problem.
What's that?
That he'll actually speak to me.
Well, Ella might be a help. She talked to the prince, you know.
What?
She went to the ball, and they talked about the kingdom and how to make things better. And tonight, she's going to the banquet.
Oh, but this world is upside down. But do you know what this means? If Ella spoke to the prince, then that means I can speak to him. And he'll be open to my suggestions. What do you call this feeling I have?
Optimism.
Optimism. I have to do this more often.
You can march up to the prince and talk to him.
I can march up to the prince and talk to
him. You can be a leader.
I can be a leader.
You can be my boyfriend.
I can be your boyfriend. Oh, left turn. What are you doing exactly? This seems very counter-revolutionary.
I like the man who wants to change the world, but I also like the man who bought me flowers.
Who brought you flowers? Oh. I did. No, I couldn't.
You said it yourself. Optimism.
Optimism?
Let yourself go.
I could be your boyfriend?
Yes.
Yes. Am I your boyfriend?
Yes.
Yes.
Mama.
So that's how it is, huh? My daughter. My own flesh and blood deceiving me with someone decidedly so unsuitable. I had plans for you, Gabrielle. I had your whole life planned out for you, and this is how you show your gratitude?
All dressed and ready for court. How do I look?
And you? Do you really think that you could go to court? I never loved your father. I only wanted him for his money. You have been a nuisance to me ever since the day he died. You think you could wear a beautiful gown? You think that is acceptable? You should be in rags! Worn out rags is all you deserve!
Mother, please stop!
And you, Gabrielle, you are no longer my daughter. Out of this house, leave! You are no longer welcome here! I'll figure out what to do with you later. Why did you have to make me doubt myself? I was doing so well.
A friendly face.
Ella, you must hurry. You shall be late for the banquet.
No! Look, everything is ruined.
Ella, hurry. The prince wants you. He needs
you. No! I can't.
Why do you think he's having the second event tonight to try to find you?
Every time I take a step forward, Madame pushes me back. The prince would never love me if he saw me for who I truly was. I can't keep fighting.
If you have a dream, then very soon thereafter, you're going to have to fight for it. Why, otherwise, how else would you know that the dream is yours?
But my life!
Exactly. It is your life. Beyond the voice that keeps insisting no, there is something more than doubting.
Midnight. Was there anything else?
Well, you already have the glass slippers. Oh, yes, the book. The book that John Michelle gave you, the one about the world. Now you will only have the whole world to help you.
Now you can go.
Majestic Highness, I believe all the guests have arrived. It is time for the banquet.
I'm waiting for her. She has to come.
Very well, sire, but be warned. This party's a pack of gossips. I'd hurry along if I were you.
Prince Topher!
You're here.
I'm sorry I'm late. I'm so glad.
Hey, I knew if I had a banquet, you'd come.
I'm sorry I ran away before.
And you're even more beautiful than I remember.
Did you really have this banquet just for me?
I would have 100 banquets to find you.
Really?
Yes.
And the thing about me being more beautiful than you remembered, that's real too?
Yes, of course.
Wow. What do you know about that?
I've been thinking about you. And I've been thinking of what you said about the people having their lands taken from them. The court tells me to ignore such talk, but
if you're going to be king, you're going to have to pay attention to the things people tell you to ignore.
Yes, and I want to meet all my people, not just the ones Sebastian lets me see. I just don't know how. It's impossible.
Well, that's going to be more possible than you can even imagine. My friend Jean-Michel and my sister Gabrielle are headed here right now with some of your people.
To talk to me, but if things are as bad as you say, then they'll be angry with me.
I think if you can do battle with a giant or dragon, I think you can handle a few people who just want to talk to you.
Okay, you're good.
Just be yourself, and they'll see the man that I see. They're coming!
Wait, what's your name?
Just trust me, because I'm your one true friend. Friends, come, meet Prince Topher. Just don't say my name.
I won't say your name, and I won't even mention that gold dress.
Are you all right?
Yes. Jean-Michel is a wonderful man with a lot of brilliant ideas.
No. It's nice to meet you.
And my sister, Gabrielle. This is Yvonne and her baby.
I see the resemblance.
And this is Sam.
It's an honor to meet you, sir.
It's an honor to meet you, too.
Hey, you know what? This is actually all right.
Okay, I'm holding a baby.
You can talk to him as if he's a real person.
Prince Topher, Jean-Michel has something he'd like to say to you.
These people have had their land taken away from them. I know I've said this before, but I now know what it means to have someone you love truly lose their home. We need your help. We need to have our voices heard.
Yes, trust me. I know what it's like to be overlooked. I want to help you, but how?
Fol-de-roi and fiddle-dee-dee, fiddle-dee-faddle-dee-faddle. All the dreamers in the world go whoops and out they tumble.
Of course, it's here.
What's here?
Do you know it?
I read it at university.
Look, chapter 2.
Of course, chapter 2.
Chapter 2? I never got that far.
Chapter 2. I should have known. People, I think I have a plan.
I knew you would.
Long live Prince Topher.
Our future king.
Prince Topher, what are you doing surrounded by these ragamuffins?
Sebastian, you said nobody needed my help. What do you call these people?
Well, from their attire, I assume artists.
We demand to have our voices heard.
Here. A beheading wouldn't be out of place here.
Yes, everyone must be heard. That's an amazing idea.
What is going on?
Now there's a way for all to be seen and heard. It's in this book. In 1 month, we will all vote for a new job. I will create the post of prime minister, someone who'll counsel me. I nominate our current Lord Protector, Sebastian.
Oh. I am unworthy, sire.
I also nominate this man, Jean-Michel.
What?
Let the people decide the way things are and the way things could be. Now everyone, rich and poor, shall have one vote.
One vote, one person? Where's the fun in that?
People, in 1 month I give you an election!
Huzzah!
Yes, that's an amazing idea. Now everyone, rich and poor, into the castle for a free banquet!
Yeah!
You did it! I knew you would!
I did do it! And I think I know who I am now.
You're smiling. I've seen you smile before, but never like that.
I know the king I can be now. Just, fair, kind-hearted. And you showed me the way.
You seem so sure of yourself. So sure of everything.
I feel like I can answer any question that gets thrown at me.
You can.
With you, I can. There's only one question I don't know the answer for.
I love you because...
Do I love you because you're wonderful? Or are you wonderful because I love you? Are you making believe I see in you a girl too lovely to be really true? Do I want you because you're wonderful? Or are you wonderful because I want you? Are you the sweet invention of a lover's dream? Or are you really as wonderful as you seem?
Now, I think we can really change the world, you and I.
To the banquet?
To the banquet.
Oh, what time is it?
Only midnight, why?
Midnight? I have to go!
What? Again?
I don't want to go, but I must.
How can you leave me? Why do you leave me?
If you saw me for who I truly was, you would never love me.
Don't leave me.
I must go.
Please, guards! Please, someone! Please, help!
Well, a great day in the kingdom. In 1 month marks our first free election for Prime Minister of the land. Our candidates are our current Lord and Protector, Sebastian, and of course, Jean Mitchell. But first, all women come to the palace to try on the glass slipper. Whosoever fits it shall be married to the prince. That was the biggest newscasting I've ever casted. I'll be back at 11 with weather and sports. Hear ye, hear ye. The prince intends to search until he finds the girl who fits the bill. Well, not the bill, the shoe, I mean the shoe to fit a queen. The shoe does not fit. The shoe does
We have to find her. The shoe's made of glass, so it must only fit one person. That's why she left it, right?
It does not look good.
How goes it?
So far, no luck.
Now, make sure you try on the shoe first, and make sure that you make eye contact with His Highness.
Don't you be the only? No one's seen Cinderella since you yelled at her 2 days ago. Oh, and you kicked out Gabrielle because she likes that guy who might be our new prime minister. Great job there.
I don't know what's wrong with this world. Everything I thought was holy and true is now trash. Everything that meant nothing to me now means everything.
Me again. Hey.
Gabrielle, I've decided if I become prime minister, I'm going to marry you.
Wow, the stakes are really piling up.
It does not fit.
Of course it doesn't fit. I'm not the girl the prince has fallen in love with. None of us are that girl.
Is she really the last eligible lady in the kingdom?
She appears to be, yes.
She can't be.
I told you she wouldn't show. Can we please end this charade?
Did everyone truly try on the slipper?
I haven't tried on the slipper.
Everything you have done has led you to this moment. Now you have something else to believe in. Yourself.
You can do it.
That's my sister.
Have we met before?
Yes, and we are seeing each other for the very first time right now.
The shoe fits! It is you. You who danced with me, you who showed me my kingdom, you who gave me water when I was thirsty. Please don't run away again. I don't think I could bear it.
I know how poorly I've treated you since your father has passed away. I'm not sure if I'm worthy of your famous kindness. I'm not worthy.
Madame, you have treated me very poorly indeed. But now I say to you the three kindest words I know. I forgive you.
Thank you.
Do you think that might include me?
For you, that includes several hours of community service.
You're amazing. Do you think I could maybe learn your name now?
Cinderella.
Cinderella, it's beautiful.
It's a name I once hated, but starting today I'll keep. So that whenever anyone thinks something is impossible, they'll just say my name and know better.
Cinderella, I love you so much. I don't know what to do.
Oh, well, is marriage still on the table?
Yes, oh my, yes, you have to marry me. I mean, Cinderella, will you marry me? Sorry. Cinderella, will you marry me?
Yes, my handsome prince, I will marry you. In the arms of my love, I'm flying.
candles.
Yeah!
amazing show, right? Thank you, FCS band and Mr. Yeah! Tindall and Mr. Curry. Amazing. Thank you, Janine Stemmer, and your musical directors, and Doug McCall on piano. We would now like to move into a very special tradition we have here at FCS, where the last show, the big spring show, we honor our seniors. This is senior night, so woo, there's a lot of them this year. And I'm gonna try to control my emotions as we do this. So we're gonna go down the line here and announce each senior and how many years that they have participated with us. So first I have Jose Cabrera. This is his first show with drama. And then I have Houston Davis has also been doing it. You've been doing it longer, so you have to wait. This is, Houston's been with us for 2 years. Emily for 2 years. Emily Rodriguez. Nicole Gonzalez. For 2 years, who I don't know how we could do these shows without her. It would be impossible. Alejandro Canino, for 2 years. Emmanuel Gonzalez, for 2 years. And Gabo Martinez, for 2 years. Morgan Munoz for 3 years. I know, the flowers can't move with me, so you guys have to. Matthew Munoz, 3 years. Thank you. Gabriela Membreno, 3 years. Oh my goodness. Sebastian Alvarez, 3 years. Marissa Vaina, 3 years. Gabby Portillo, 4 years. And now I get to some really hard ones because these guys have been with me since sixth and seventh grade. And they're like, you know, kids. They all are like my kids. But so Wilkin Caceres. 6 years. Melanie Gonzalez for 6 years. And Jack Nelson, sixth grade, 7 years. And I think somewhere out there I have another child, Jonathan Estrada, that wasn't in the show, but he was in drama also for 6 years. So this one's for you. And we love you. We're graduating a lot of amazing people. I'm so proud of who you are and your character and your hard work, and I'm just, we'll be praying for you as you move on, and we're going to enjoy the rest of the time we have with you. God bless you. We love you so much. And thank you so much for coming. My band seniors. No. My band seniors. Sorry, would you guys come up, please? Would you use the stairs over there? I'd like to honor the band seniors as well.
We're going to bow.
I have Sophia. Did Sophie make it up here yet? Where's Sophia? Hey, Sophia Vieira. Francis Pozo. Annette Dominguez. Amy Suarez. And Juliet Bryant. Let's hear it for our seniors. Thank you so much for coming and supporting FCS Arts. It's an honor to work together and to collaborate like this. I'm so thankful. Good night.
Uh.
Clearly, I'm a little emotional right now. And now, you may kiss the stage.
There you go.
Wait, why? No.
Before we close, you know, tonight's a night where we honor seniors and people who have been in this department for so long, pouring, you know, hours and working on a production. And really, we've really built a family here in drama. I'm so proud of every single one of these individuals. Putting on a production and making art together really unifies. And I think it's so beautiful that here we are now, all graduating soon, and we're standing in front of you guys, our parents, our friends and family. Thank you for coming all together. And the lights are on us, but now I want to focus my attention to someone very special by the name of Mrs. Bryan. Can we all get a round of applause? Mrs. Bryan has really transcended being an educator. She is more than an educator. Yes, she wants us to be amazing actors and professional actors, but more importantly, she wants us to be amazing individuals. She wants to see the best versions of ourselves day in and day out, and she instills that in her classroom every day. And for somebody like I have, that I've been taking her class for 6 years, it's truly a blessing to have a teacher like that. So, without further ado, thank you, Mrs. Bryan, for everything you do. Woo! Could you bring the flowers out? Thank you so much.
I dropped the whole stem.
They're going to be around to see you soon. Good night. Thank you so much.
More!
We forgot about the officers.